for a good appetite. It's right here, and I can't wait for tomorrow to see a little belly.
Well, good evening, Sumter School District boys and girls, and welcome to a special evening of Reading with the Superintendent. During the holiday season, we want to make sure that you continue to engage your mind and entertain through reading. So tonight we're going to continue to read, and we have a special book that we're going to read, but I have an even more special book. We have Officer Arroyo with us. Well, hello there, Officer Arroyo. How are you?
Hello, I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm great. I'm excited to have you here with me.
And I'm excited to be here, so thank you for having me.
Why don't you share a little bit about you and your experiences with our viewers so they'll know who's sharing time with you tonight.
Okay. Well, I'm Officer Arroyo with the Sumter Police Department. I've been with the department for about a year and 5 months, so a little over a year. I'm not from South Carolina. I'm from Texas. I was born in Houston, grew up most of my life in Brownsville, Texas. If you ever look at the map, because a lot of people don't know where Brownsville is, go to the bottom of Texas. It's right at the borderline of Mexico. That's where you would find me and my family.
Well, we're excited to have you here in South Carolina. And we have one thing in common. We are both from another state. I'm from Maryland. So if you go up the side of the map and look in the corner, it's right there.
I see it.
So you said your name a little different than I said your name. So is Arroyo the correct way to say it, or?
If you got to roll the R a bit, it's Arroyo.
Arroyo.
Yeah.
Arroyo.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, did I do it?
Yes, you did.
Yeah, okay. Well, I'll continue to practice with Officer Arroyo. So do you roll your tongue because there's two R's, or do you roll your tongue if there's one R?
I roll my tongue because there's two R's. Arroyo.
Oh. I just want to make sure that I pronounce your name correctly, because, you know, sometimes it can be offensive to people if you don't say their names correctly.
Take no offense to it. I understand.
And people have always said my name wrong all my life. And my name is Penelope, but people call me Penelope. And I answer because all of my friends growing up were primarily Greek. And they would call my name and say Penelope. And I answered because that's the correct. But anyway, enough of my name. So I'm ready to read. But I see you have a special guest.
I do.
Who's that?
It's my good friend, the Cat in the Hat, as people would say in Spanish, el gato en sombrero.
Say that again so we can learn cat.
Cat is el gato, hat en sombrero.
I love that. And I know our viewers love it too, because I always share with them that we need to have versatility in two different languages or multiple languages so that we can show an appreciation for our peers and our colleagues. So I'm ready to begin. Are you ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
So I want to make sure that I have our viewers, I have their attention. So I do this call and response type of action just to make sure I have all their attention. And it goes like this. One, two, three, all eyes on me.
One, two, all eyes on you.
Let's begin to read The Cat in the Hat, or El Gato en Sombrero. Did I say it right?
Yes, you did.
Okay, all right. Thank you. Thank you. The Cat, let me ask you a question.
Yes.
There's a fish.
There is.
How do you say fish in Spanish?
Pescado.
Say it again.
Pescado.
Pescado.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. What about umbrella?
I honestly don't know that, if we're being honest.
Okay, so we can say it's umbrella.
Umbrella.
That's what we'll do. So let's go ahead and begin. The Cat in the Hat, Dr. Seuss. The sun did not shine. It was too wet to play. So we sat in the house all that cold, cold, wet. So, Officer Arroyo, because we're trying to expand our vocabulary, how do you say sun in Spanish?
Sol.
Sol, okay. Mm-hmm. And how do you say play?
Jugar.
Okay. And what about house?
House, casa.
Like, mi casa es su casa?
Yes, it is.
Hey, okay. See, didn't know I knew that, right? Mm-hmm.
I sat there with Sally. We sat there, we two. And I said how I wish we had something to do. Too wet to go out and too cold to play ball. So we sat in the house. We did nothing at all. So all we could do was to sit, and we did not like it. No, not one little bit.
So what do you usually do when it's cold outside?
Usually when it's cold outside nowadays, I watch Netflix. And I make it into a movie day.
Movie day? Mm-hmm. Well, I love
cold. You love the cold?
I love the cold. But I'll tell you something. I love the cold, but I don't like being cold.
I can agree with you on that.
Okay. So how do you say cold in Spanish?
Frío.
Okay. And can you read on page 3? So we could, all we could do was sit. And that's how you say Spanish? How do you say sit in Spanish?
Sentar.
Okay. So all we could do was
sentarnos.
Absolutely. Good job. I like that. I think and then something went bump. How that bump made us jump. Okay, Officer Arroyo, I'm going to ask you a question.
I'm ready.
I'm ready for expanding my vocabulary. How do you say bump in Spanish?
Bump.
Oh. Okay. So I learned a new Spanish word.
Bump. One of the easiest you learn. But you do say jump, brincar.
Oh. Say that again for me?
Jump is brincar.
Okay. I like that. Thank you for adding that.
You're welcome. So we looked, then we saw him step in on the mat. We looked and we saw him, the cat in the hat. And he said to us, "Why do you sit there like that? I know it is wet and the sun is not sunny, but we can have lots of good fun that is funny."
So how do we say mat in Spanish? So another big word.
Yeah, mat. It's a big word.
We're going to say Spanish is
mat.
What about sunny?
Sunny? It's the same like sol.
Okay.
It's the only difference is when it's not sunny, it's not brillando. So it means it's not bright. So the sol naturally is sunny.
Okay. I like it sunny and cold.
I like it not sunny sometimes.
But you're from Texas.
That's why it's hot all the time.
I know some good games we could play, said the cat. I know some new tricks, said the cat in the hat. A lot of good tricks, I will show them to you. Your mother will not mind at all if I do. Then Sally and I did not know what to say. Our mother was out of the house for the day. There's a lot of new words I would like to say in Spanish. So how do you say mother?
Mama.
Mama. How do you say game?
Juegos.
Say that one again.
Juegos. It's close to jugar, playing, and games.
Okay. New words, new vocabulary.
But our fish said, "No, no. Make that cat go away. Tell that cat in the hat you do not want to play. He should not be here. He should not be about. He should not be here when your mother is out."
That's good advice. Not having company when your parents aren't home.
I agree with you.
I think it can cause some problems.
We will see as we get further down the book.
Yes, we will see. Now, have no fear, said the cat in the hat. My tricks are not bad. Why, we can have lots of good fun if you wish, with a game that I call up with a fish. Put me down, said the fish. This is no fun at all. Put me down, said the fish. I do not wish to fall. Oh, the fish can talk. Have you ever heard of a talking fish?
This is the first time I've heard of a talking fish, if we're being honest.
Oh, okay. So how do you say put me down?
Bájame abajo.
I like that. I'm going to have to start telling people, put me down. Oh, I don't think I've been picked up.
I would not want to be picked up. Not in the style that the fish is at. Have no fear, said the cat. I will not let you fall. I will hold you up high and as I stand on the ball. With a book on one hand and a cup on my hat, but that is not all I can do, said the cat. So, book, you say libro. Mm-hmm. See how you kind of roll the R on that a bit too? Book. Libro. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, is it el libro or el libro?
El libro.
Okay, why is it libro? That's gender neutral?
Yeah, it's gender neutral. Oh. That's a good question.
Look at me. Look at me now, said the cat, with a cup and a cake on the top of my head. I can hold up two books. I can hold up one fish and a little toy ship and some milk on a dish. And look, I can hop up and down on the ball. That is not all. Oh, no. That is not all. He's talented.
Very talented. That's very multitasking right there.
Can your cat in the hat do this?
I don't know, but that's a challenge he's willing to take.
I like when challenges are taken. That's how you grow.
But we do like cake. In Spanish, you call that pastel.
Oh, I love
especially
pastel.
For birthdays.
Mm-hmm. You know what my favorite part of the birthday cakes are?
Little part.
Just the icing.
Not gonna lie, that's my favorite too. I can eat icing by itself.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a dish.
Look at me. Look at me. Look at me now. It is fun to have fun, but you have to know how. I can hold up the cup and the milk and the cake. I can hold up these books and the fish on a rake. I can hold the toy ship and a little toy man. And look, with my tail, I can hold a red fan. I can fan with the fan as I hop on the ball, but that is not all. Oh no, that is not all. So we see a lot of things going on here. He got three books. That would be tres libros. And he has milk. Milk in Spanish is leche. I'm not a big fan of leche though.
You're not?
I'm not. I'm lactose intolerant. If I wasn't, I'd probably be a fan of it, but unfortunately, I'm not.
I love leche in the form of ice cream.
Well, I still eat ice cream.
Okay. He's just talented. I wish I could do that. I think we can practice that. What do you think?
That's a challenge I'll take.
Okay. That is what the cat said. Then he fell on his head. He came down with a bump from up there on the ball. And Sally and I, we saw all the things fall. Oh, boy.
So everything fell. Todo se cayó. He made a mess. So ball in Spanish is pelota.
Mm-hmm. What else?
Ship. You can say barco. You want to try saying barco?
Barco.
Barco. There you go. You got it.
A check for me?
For you. I'll give you an A+.
Appreciate that. I always work hard for good grades.
And our fish came down too. He fell into a pot. He said, do I like this? Oh no, I do not. This is not a good game, said our fish as he lit. No, I do not like it. Not one little bit.
I don't know if that fish is going to survive after that.
It just might. He looks pretty strong for a tiny fish.
Uh-oh. Now look what you did, said the fish to the cat. Now look at this house. Look at this. Look at that. You sank our toy ship, sank it deep in the cake. You shook up our house and you bent our new rake. You should not be here when your mother is not. You get out of this house. Said the fish in the pot. Get out of this casa.
Out of this casa. That fish does not look happy, like he's not happy with the cat in the hat.
But what about the little people in the corner? They're shocked.
I think they might be scared.
Yeah, I think they should be.
I know I would.
Yeah.
But I like to be here. Oh, I like it a lot, said the cat in the hat to the fish in the pot. I will not go away. I do not wish to go. And so said the Cat in the Hat. So, I will show you another good game that I know. The cat just wants to keep playing games.
He does.
I'm guessing he likes games. In Spanish, we like to say, me gusta juegos. Okay.
So what kind of games do you like?
I usually recently been playing Xbox games. But if I'm outside, I like being active and I'll play basketball.
Do you play? Do you have skill?
I mean, I think I do. I hope I do. You should be the judge of that one day.
I think I'm the judge of whether you can play basketball, unless that's a challenge. Because if it is,
we can play one on one.
We can do that.
Okay. Let's do it.
Okay, it's on. You've heard it here. Just don't judge me.
Never judge me.
And then he ran out. And then, fast as a fox, the Cat in the Hat came back in with a box. A big red wood box. It would shut with a hook. Now look at this trick, said the cat. Take a look. So how do you say red?
Rojo.
Rojo.
And box? Caja. That looks like a pretty big box. I can't wait to see what's inside.
If I were getting that box, you know what I would like to have in it?
What would you like to have in it?
My favorite thing.
Shoes? That looks like it can contain a lot of different shoes. Then he got up on top with the tip of his hat. I call this game Fun in a Box, said the cat. In the box are two things I will show to you now. You will like these two things, said the cat with a bow.
So,
two things.
You said there were two things in the box. How do you say two in Spanish?
Dos. And things you call cosas.
What about bow?
Bow?
Since the cat now has this red bow.
I'm not sure.
Okay. We're just going to call it?
A bow.
A bow?
Let's do that.
Okay. I will pick up the hook. You will see something new. Two things. And I call them thing one and thing two. These things will not bite you. They want to have fun. Then out of the box came thing one, thing two, I apologize, came thing two and thing one. And they ran to us fast. They said, how do you do? Would you like to shake hands with thing one and thing two? You know what just happened. I am so familiar with the book, I closed my eyes and was getting excited and flipped my words. But it's okay because I recovered from that mistake. Did I do okay?
You did great.
Okay.
You wouldn't even notice. So we got thing one, thing two. Cosa número uno, cosa número dos. And they got blue hair. Mm-hmm. Azul is blue. Pelo is hair. So they got pelo azul.
And did I tell them they were going to be tested on these charms later?
I believe you did.
Okay.
And Sally and I did not know what to do, so we had to shake hands with thing one and thing two. He shook their two hands, but our fish said no, no. Those things should not be here, should not be in this house. Make them go. They should not be here when your mother is not. Put them out, set the fish in the pot. That fish don't seem like he's happy about this.
Well, I was going to say, why is the fish still in the pot?
If he could walk out of that, I'm pretty sure he would.
Watch your word. Have no fear, little fish, said the cat in the hat. These things are good things. And he gave them a pat. They are tame, oh, so tame. They have come here to play. They will give you some fun on this wet, wet, wet day. Thing one, thing two. Thing uno, thing dos.
That is correct. Do you happen to know how to say wet in Spanish?
I do not. Will you teach me?
It's mojado.
Mojado. Okay. Thank you.
No problem. That is why they couldn't play outside. Because it was too wet.
Wet. Hey, I was going to say orajo, but my tongue felt a little slow.
Now here is a game that they like, said the cat. They like to fly kites, said the cat in the hat. No, not in the house, said the fish in the pot. They should not fly kites in a house. They should not. Oh, the things they will bump. Oh, the things they will hit. Oh, I do not like it. Not one little bit. I'm starting to think that the cat doesn't, the cat likes having fun. I don't think the fish enjoys having any of this fun. I don't think he's that happy about that.
How did you say kite?
Kite. That's a good question. I wish I knew, but I don't.
But what we're going to do is we're going to do this. In English, it's
kite. Kite.
And in Spanish, it's
kite. Kite.
It's called improvising.
Absolutely.
Then Sally and I saw them run down the hall. We saw those two things bump their kites on the wall. Bump, thump, thump, bump. Down the wall in the hall. How do you say bump and thump?
Bump and thump.
Okay.
And that's exactly what all the kites did to the house. Then those things ran about with big bumps, jumps, and kicks, and with hops and big thumps, and all kinds of bad tricks. And I said, I do not like the way that they play. If mother could see this, oh, what would she say? Do you see that dress?
I do.
My mom loves wearing dress. We call those vestidos. Vestidos. And it's white with polka dots. They did a big mess.
Well, wait a minute. Are those the same two dresses? Yeah, it's the same dress.
Yeah.
I thought it was going to be a different dress. But guess not. Then our fish said, look, look. And our fish shook with fear. Your mother is on her way home. Do you hear? Oh, what will she do to us? What will she say? Oh, she will not like it to find it. Us this way. That fish seems to be the reasonable one.
I agree. I would not want to be those kids right now if that was their mom.
She's coming.
So do something fast, said the fish. Do you hear? I saw her, your mother. Your mother is near. So as fast as you can, think of something to do. You will have to get rid of thing one and thing two. Oh no.
But I think I would like to have thing one and thing two as a friend.
Well, since they're two, you can have one and I'll have two.
Oh, I like the way you think. You're sharing.
Because sharing is always best and it's caring.
Absolutely. So as fast as I could, I went after my net. And I said with my net, I can get them, I bet. I bet with my net, I can get those things yet. Oh, Lord. They are having fun.
I'm surprised the fish is not with the net trying to grab thing one and thing two. Then I let down my net. It came down with a plop. And I had them at last. Those two things had to stop. Then I said to the cat, now you do as I say. You pack up those things and you take them away. Oh dear, said the cat, you did not like our game? Oh dear, what a shame, what a shame, what a shame. That's how you say plop
in Spanish. I was going to ask you how to say plop in Spanish.
Exactly how you say in English, plop.
Plop. Then he shut up the things in the box with the hook, and the cat went away with a sad kind of look. That is good, said the fish. He has gone away. Yes, but your mother will come. She will find this big mess, and this mess is so big and so deep and so tall, we cannot pick it up. There is no way at all.
That is a big mess.
It is.
Well, we like to say that's a sucio casa.
Sucio casa.
Mm-hmm. Nobody likes a dirty house.
Absolutely not.
And then, who's back in the house? Why, the cat. Have no fear of this mess, said the cat in the hat. I always pick up all my playthings, and so I will show you another good trick that I know. What's a cat trying to redeem himself?
It does. I like the car.
I do too.
The car has multiple mechanisms on it to help clean out.
It sure does. Car in Spanish is carro. And we've already gone over red, so how do you say red in Spanish?
Rojo?
Correct. You got it.
Do I get another check?
Yep, another check. We're adding stickers to your wall.
Thank you. Then we saw him pick up all the things that were down. He picked up the cake and the rake and the gown and the milk and the strings and the books and the dish and the fan and the cup and the chip and the fish, and he put them over him. Then he said, that is that. And then he was gone with the tip of his hat. Or the tip of his sombrero.
Sombrero. Looks like he cleaned up pretty well, if you tell me.
I think that car helped to break it.
I think so too. But he was driving it.
You think we can create one of those?
I think if we put enough people to do it, I think we can.
Okay.
Then our mother came in. And she said to us too, did you have any fun? Tell me, what did you do? And Sally and I did not know what to say. Should we tell her the things that went on there that day? Should we tell her about it? Now, what should we do? Well, what would you do if your mother asked you to?
Hello?
I wonder what you would do. Would you tell your mother the truth?
I would.
I would too.
I would.
I might be a little scared, but... the truth will set you free at the end.
At the end. In the beginning, too.
That's
so
right.
When the cat in the hat arrives, the children's gloomy day is immediately brightened. And you know I can say my day was brightened with having this time.
Well, thank you for having me. I had a lot of fun.
I did likewise. And I know that our viewers had fun. And I know they learned a great deal. And it's all thanks to you.
Well, thank you for having me.
Thank you for being here. And let me just end with this. Let me just, they said, tip their hats in the book. And I'm going to tip my sombrero that I don't have on. But I do want to, in all sincerity, thank you for what you do each and every day to protect and serve our community and to be a role model for our children, because you are absolutely remarkable. And I just appreciate you being here with us.
Thank you. Those are very kind words. We appreciate everything that we do for you guys.
Thank you so much. And to our viewers, we'll see you the next time. Evening reading with the superintendent. Adios, Officer Arroyo.
Adios.
Time to take it, no time to waste. Things are getting better for you. So I get on the move by night.